Today's video is sponsored by the CDL. Major 4 officially begins tomorrow on July 14th, and it runs all the way into the 17th. This is the last major of the 2022 season. If you'd like to be there in person, you can pick up tickets available right now. Link in the description below. And just like the previous tournaments, Major 4 is also going to provide viewership rewards for everybody watching back at home. As long as you link your Activision account to your YouTube account and watch the stream live, you'll be earning viewership rewards like calling cards, emblems, and even a weapon blueprint. And don't forget, double XP is also earnable all season long by simply tuning in and watching the tournament. So just as a reminder, Major 4 begins tomorrow. Don't miss out on those viewership rewards or your tickets. Visit that link down below if you want to be there in person. And I should also mention, COD Champs tickets are also available. That's going to be going on August 4th through the 7th. If you want to get your tickets today and secure your position to see greatness, visit that link in the description below. Big thank you to the CDL for sponsoring today's video. Let's get into it. Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about 7 different things that I'm really excited for when it comes to the release of Modern Warfare 2. Remember to leave the things that you're most excited for down below in the comment section. Let's get kicking off with number 7, and that to me is OG maps and operators returning in some capacity. We already know that High Rise from the original Modern Warfare 2 will be returning. It's going to be part of this overarching larger ground war experience, and most likely will be there as a 6v6 experience as well. In a world where we don't ever know if the original Modern Warfare 2 remastered multiplayer will ever release, I'm happy to say that at least we're going to be getting some maps from the original MW2 High Rise being officially confirmed at this point. And with our operators returning, I'm excited simply for the fact to see the continuation of their story. We know that there's been a little bit of time between the story of MW 2019 and of course MW2, so seeing how they've developed and progressed and where they're at now is going to be a pretty interesting situation. And that kind of leads me into the number 6 thing, and that is the storylines for these operators. Each one of these operators throughout the entirety of Modern Warfare 2019 had their own little piece to the story in some way, shape, or form. Whether it was described through the Spec Ops experience or because we were going to be doing a brand new event through one of the 6 seasons we had during MW 2019, it's going to be really nice to see once again how those stories have developed for these characters. And it does make me wonder if that's going to be reflected in the character models as well. Like, for example, throughout the years, did they get into any engagements that left them with body disfigurement? Do we have any situations like with Nikto where he had a split personality? Is he going to be acting completely different now? And this leads us into the number 5 spot, which is the Spec Ops story. I'm really curious if we're going to be seeing the story from the perspective of after the campaign again, like we did in MW 2019, or is it going to be a situation where we're telling these stories based off of the operators around them? That way we can actually kind of relive where these operators were through the Spec Ops story to catch us up even more to the continuation with Modern Warfare 2. Honestly, I think that would be a pretty cool opportunity for them to add DLC and another Spec Ops mission per DLC character to give us a story about where they were, what they were doing, and why it was important to their background. Moving into that number 4 spot, I'm just going to say 6v6 multiplayer and how the maps are going to evolve. We already know that there's going to be a lot of different ways to play with Modern Warfare 2 in terms of its movement. We know swimming is making a return. We also know that free hanging on ledges will be a thing, as well as a different type of climbing. And I would assume that the team at IW wants to show this off in all of its glory, very similar to how they added a bunch of doors when that was brand new and introduced in Modern Warfare 2019. So it's going to be interesting to see how that all comes together, not to mention all of the different pieces of equipment and field upgrades that we're going to have playing a massive role across the entire multiplayer map, depending on where we have decoys and tactical cameras and all that different type of stuff. It's going to be very cool to see. So that leads us into the number 3 spot, which is Ground War Shenanigans. You take everything we just discussed with 6v6 multiplayer and how the map could evolve, and you slam it into a wide open map with now vehicles that you're able to pilot, vehicles that you're able to drive, vehicles that you can destroy, new mechanics there where you can hang out the window and you can actually ride on top of the car. So you're basically surfing on the top of vehicles and you're able to do all of this as the driver. But the best part is it's just the beginning, and it's only what's been revealed. We don't really know how big these maps are going to be because we haven't seen them officially yet, but I am excited to say that I'm sure there's going to be plenty of rooftops to explore, plenty of ledges to hang on, plenty of water, and plenty of boats and vehicles and helicopters and all this different stuff to get into some crazy over-the-top action. And honestly, it makes me kind of sad to think that we're not going to have a theater mode in order to take advantage of all of this awesome over-the-top stuff happening in real time. Because I want to tell you, I've been thinking about all the different stuff that we can do with vehicles. I want to take an ATV or a small vehicle and throw a tactical camera on it with maybe a couple C4, drive into the back of the transport helicopter, lift that up into the air, go as high as we possibly can, and then as we're flying, back the car out of the helicopter, jump out and stay in the helicopter, but use the tactical camera to see it hit the ground. And as soon as it does, explode that C4 and have just a moving bomb coming out of the back of the thing. And I think that would be freaking fantastic. And that's why I'm so excited for Ground War. But taking that number two spot is our newest operator, Alejandro Vargas. As we all know, he's going to be working alongside Task Force 141, and from what I'm able to understand and what we've been officially told from the team at Infinity Ward, he's not officially a member, he's more of an honorary member. He's part of the Mexican Special Forces, and in a situation during the campaign, all we know so far, and I'm trying to keep it as spoiler-free as possible, is he rescues Ghost from a situation where he cannot rescue himself. And that's how they're introduced to this particular character. So he is quite mysterious. I'm interested in seeing how this will, of course, affect the campaign and, of course, moving forward into the multiplayer. But there's been a lot of rumors online about whether or not Alejandro is a good guy or a bad guy. I'm under the impression that he's going to be a good guy all the way through. I can't imagine going through with all this promotional material to make him seem like he's part of Task Force 141, only to have that twist ending where he turns out to be a bad guy. Although, then again, we did see what happened with General Shepard, and I guess anything's possible at this point. Now, last but certainly not least is the Mastery Camo Grind. Just like every single year with Call of Duty, many of us, hundreds of thousands of us, go for the Mastery Camo in the multiplayer experience. And it's actually one of the things that I look forward to every single year. Alongside this being a prestige mode, but we haven't had that in 3 years, and I'm not really holding my breath that they're going to be doing it any differently this time around. Although I would be very surprised, and you can guarantee that I'd make a video on it as soon as I learn more. But as of right now, all I have to say about the Mastery Camo is I'm hoping that it's bigger and better than it's ever been ever before. Like, it's awesome to have gold, diamond, and then that super secret Mastery Camo. In the case of MW 2019, we of course had gold, platinum, and Damascus. And that was cool because it was out of the ordinary. I think a lot of people missed diamond at that point, and instead of adding that, we ended up getting obsidian, which was a really cool thing to add, you know, halfway through the year or whatever it was when they added it. I'm hoping with MW2 we see the Mastery Camo get expanded a little bit to allow a little more customization. So instead of just having a gold camo, maybe we can cycle through gold, platinum, silver, bronze, and give us different ways to earn those on each individual weapon after unlocking that particular category. Then they could go to diamond or provide ruby, emerald, sapphire, and give us a bunch of different ways to unlock those other types of camos in that same category with that weapon after unlocking. And then finally, we could have the big, huge mastery camo, which I don't know what they plan on doing. I just really hope that it's super cool, looks super nice, and I can't wait to see just exactly what this grind has in store for everybody out there. But that is the seven things right at this moment that I'm looking forward to the most when it comes to MW2. I didn't even mention it, but the actual campaign is something that I'm looking forward to as well. I know we kind of brought it up a little bit earlier on, but the campaign is another thing that I'm very stoked to see how that's going to plan out. Just based off of everything we've gotten over the past year with Warzone and all the stories that have been retconned in certain ways and other stories that have popped up over the course of, well, the past 3 years, effectively. But anyway, that is it for this video today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming every day. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I will catch you on the next one. Peace.